This is Survival Radio Network, and thank you for helping us to reach over 2 million downloads. You're listening to The Paula G Show, where we expand the mindset through worldwide conversations. You can stay connected with us by visiting my website at paulagvoice.com. You can join The Paula G Show Facebook group page. You can also like the Paula G business page or My Journey with Paula G business page, and you can subscribe to my growing YouTube channel as we're launching a Fit at 60 and Beyond campaign, which highlights some of the aspects of my book, My Journey to Lady Wisdom After Midnight, which is now available on Amazon in paperback and Kindle. You have questions, comments, concerns, you'd like to be a guest or offer underwriter opportunities, you can email Paula at paulagvoice.com as well. You can also find this show, the playbacks, on iTunes, Mixcloud, TuneIn Radio, and Stitcher Radio. Much love and shouts out to V. Ferg for the opening and closing theme music for The Paula G Show, and his music can be found on Spotify, iTunes, and Tidal. Well, you know, I have been saying this for a long time, that time is so incredibly precious. It's the one thing that we certainly cannot get back, and we're seeing that more and more in this, I'm trying not to say the word, situation that we're in. So I treasure even more than ever the fact that you all think it's not robbery to spend a little bit of time with us here on The Paula G Show. I hope you're having a great day, or have had a great day, will have a great day. I pray you're staying healthy and safe during this pandemic that we are experiencing. You know, it conjures up a wave of emotions, from, you know, there is hope to sometimes with some people there's hopelessness. It can be overwhelming with all of the information that we're getting and with us doing what we can to stay safe. But somewhere in all of that, we've got to center ourselves, find a quiet place, a quiet space in the midst of all of that, where you can give yourself an opportunity, give yourself a chance to breathe, give yourself a chance to exhale, you know. And self-care right now is so incredibly, incredibly important. This is a wonderful time and a wonderful, not a wonderful time, but an opportunity for you to take care of yourself. You all have heard it before, the whole oxygen mask theory, you know, that you've got to put the oxygen mask on yourself and then put it on, you know, your child or the person next to you if they're unable to put it on themselves. You've got to take care of yourself, y'all. You've got to slow down and just center yourself. And, you know, there are a couple things that I suggest, you know, before we bring our guests on, I just want to share and encourage you a couple things that I suggest that I pray will help you all. And one is, center yourself through prayer, through meditation. I'm a Christian. I believe in Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior. You may believe the same, or you may have other beliefs, and you may worship a power higher than yourself. Whatever that looks like for you, center yourself. Pray, meditate. That can be such a calming, calming thing to do, and it can really give you clarity and perspective. So that's the first thing that you want to do, is just center yourself, spend some time in prayer, spend some time in meditation. Exercise. Now, you all know me. Exercise guru. It doesn't have to be full-fledged like I do, but you can do something. I know we're confined to our homes. From what I hear, you know, we can go outside, we can go for a walk, but of course we have to distance ourselves. You know, some say wear the mask if you're out and exercising, some say don't. Use your judgment what what you feel comfortable with. I am by no means an expert. You know, I'm just sharing some things to hopefully help get you through this. Exercise. If you can't go out, you don't want to go out, you have stairs, you can go up and down your stairs. You can, you know, do some exercises without any weights. The Fit at 60 and Beyond videos that I put out at the end, I do a 1 or 2 minute exercise piece in that to give you some ideas of what you can do. Now, some of it's a little bit intense. I realized that the other day. It's like, okay, I should probably bring it down a little bit. So the upcoming ones that I do, I'm going to bring them down a little bit and also show a bit of variation for all levels. But you can utilize that if you would like. Also, eating. Making sure that you're eating a balanced diet, which is even more challenging because we're all home, right? So I know I've kind of gone a little bit overboard with the snacking. Yes, I did. I confess. But I'm getting it together, and I'm focusing on making sure I'm eating balanced meals. You know, your fruits, your vegetables, your proteins, you know, your vitamins, your minerals, all of those things. Make sure you're eating balanced meals, but do so in moderation because we're probably not as active, you know, as we were prior to this pandemic. Also, water, 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 y'all. Make sure you're drinking some water, okay? Make sure you're drinking water. Don't get yourself dehydrated. Make sure that you're drinking some water. You know, if you need to reach out, if you need help, you know, if you feel you need to talk to a professional, a therapist, a counselor, someone of that nature, you know, they're still in business. They're doing these sessions virtually. So if you have been meeting with one on a regular basis, you know, make sure you keep those up through a virtual meeting session or through a phone call. If you have not and you're seeking one, you know, look, the best place to start is by word of mouth, friends, someone who may have a counselor or a therapist themselves that can maybe share with you that information so that you can talk to someone who is a professional to help you with whatever feelings that you're feeling as we're going through, you know, this season, because it's, you know, it's a tough season. And, you know, if you struggle with anxiety, depression, you know, phobias, things of that nature, this can be especially challenging. And, you know, our new radio personality, I'm going to call her new radio personality, Rosalyn was sharing with us last week, you know, some of her experiences and some suggestions, which are great suggestions. So if you missed it, make sure you go back and listen, and she'll share some with us a little bit later on in the show as well. So, you know, those are some things that you can do. Also, someone suggested journaling. You know, journal what you're feeling on a daily basis. It doesn't have to be anything formal. You know, you don't have to worry about your spelling and all of that. You're just getting your emotions out. You're just getting your feelings out. And I know from past experience that journaling has been very helpful for me as well. So maybe that is something that can help you. Reaching out to family, reaching out to friends, making sure everyone's okay, you know, FaceTiming them, or if you know, you can go through WhatsApp, make phone calls, but staying connected some way with the outside world, so to speak. So hopefully those are some things that, you know, can help you. Those are some things that I have incorporated and things that have been shared with me and that have been helpful. So I hope and pray that those things are helpful to you as well. And who knows, from your journaling, from your experiences, your thoughts that you have had through this whole experience, you never know, there might be a book on the other side of it. You know, you might find yourself being an author. You know, out of a lot of adversities and situations, a lot of times comes, you know, that creative juice and those creative spirit that so many are able to create. So hopefully that has helped you all some. Also, you know, the book that I wrote a while back has some lessons in it that might also be helpful. My Journey to Lady Wisdom After Midnight, which is available on Amazon and Kindle and paperback. Those are some experiences that I've had, but the lessons that I've learned may be helpful for such a time that we're in now.